together. So I thought last Sunday, you know, we raised our hands, who's gonna come to church? And I thought that so many children come here and worship together, but only Yerim come here. God bless you. Especially today's sermon I prepared for children, but only Yerim, but I think everyone, we are children of God, as
Amen.
Adam mentioned, right? So today, I want to focus on the Jacob, the story of Jacob. Let's think about we are like a Jacob position. So let me tell you, I'm a Jacob, okay? Hi, my name is Jacob. Hey, Yeri. Hi, it's me, Jacob. Do you know me? Okay, you don't know. In the book of Genesis, I was born the time my mother, her name is Rebecca. Rebecca, she was pregnant. Look at Yeri. 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, 4 months, 5 months, 6 months, 7, 8, 9. Are you ready? She gave birth to sons, at that time twins. And then I have my older brother, his name is Esau, and I greet my brother's heel. That's what Jacob. Jacob means heel. Yeri, understand? Thank you. And then Esau, do you know the meaning of Esau? Esau means the color of red color. Red color. And then you know, when you visit the desert, you see the, how about the color of the desert? Yeri? The color of desert. Guess what? Red color, excellent! If I have a candy, I'm gonna throw. Hey, catch! Okay, yeah. So, Edomite is Esau's family, they lived there. So, the color of red and hairy. Okay, then look at the picture here. Ah, I was born! Oh, very cute. My name is Jacob. And then, my brother, his job is hunter. Yeah, I can catch animals. On the other hand, Jacob, my job, you know, I'm just like a chef. I'm good chef, like a Gordon Ramsay. Or supervisor, former supervisor, Melvin, you know, Army, he is also best chef. So like, yeah, I'm a bad chef. One day, my brother is so hungry. Okay, I will do my best. And I could see over there, Jacob, he is cooking. Smell. Wow, smells really good. And Esau, he came to near to Jacob. Jacob, would you give me a soup for me? And Jacob looked at the Esau and he said, would you give me your birthright, the first son? Then I'm gonna give you a soup. Oh, what should I do? Oh, I'm so hungry. Birthright, nothing. Okay, I'm gonna give you my birthright to you. Okay, Jacob, he said, hallelujah. I'm gonna give you my soup. Yeah, that's happening. And one day, the time, my father, his name is Isaac. Isaac means smiling. The time is so old. Yerim, would you come here to me? And let you, yeah, this time the sermon together. Yerim, please come here. Yeah. Yeah. You are, okay, guess what? You are Isaac. You are over 90 years old. And your eyes are so weak. Okay, you cannot see me very clearly. And one day, my mother, her name is Rebecca, and he said to me, oh, your father, your daddy's eyes are not good, so how about you, like Esau? Oh, mom, my body is, you know, I don't have hairy. You don't worry, be happy, I brought the goat's skin. Goat skin, so and then I covered with the goat's skin, and I came to, your eyes are right. Father, I'm your Esau. And please say, okay. Father, I want to get blessing from you. And he said, are you really Jacob? Yes, I'm a Jacob. Okay, I want to touch my hand. Please do not touch my skin. I go cold skin. Yes, yes, you are my son, Esau.
Yes, you are my son.
Oh, thank you. Okay, bless me. Thank you. Thank you. Come on. Yeah, that's why Jacob got blessing from his father. And Esau, do you know the Esau, his job? Yeah, hunter. And he came back from there, came back to his house, and then Esau, he came again. Father, I'm here, I'm Esau. And he always like he said again, are you really Esau? I already blessed you. Where is Esau? I'm your father. I am here. Oh my goodness. I'm going to kill my young brother Jacob. He deprived my birthright from me. Yeah, that's happening. That's why in the night, Rebecca, Jacob's mother, she said to Jacob, come here. And in the night, depart from here, go to my brother. My brother's name's Laban, and he will protect you. Go there. So in the night, and wolf. I do my best for it, yeah, children. All of us here are children, right? I rode on the horse and it, my older brother over there. Oh, I want to go outside. Okay. And then, at last, I was very exhausted. I was so tired. I need to sleep, but I had no pillow. Where is my pillow? And I look around there. Oh, this is my pillow. Come here. Oh, pillow. But it's torn. Made of stone. Oh, too heavy. But I need to sleep. And in the dream, I could see over there, from the heaven, the angels of God, you know, up and down, with by using leather. Yeah, and then I said, this place I named Bethel. Beth means, Yerin, repeat after Beth. Beth. Beth means house. El means God. The house of God. That's it. That is for the sermon for children. Okay, now it's for our people. So, oh, I spent so much energy. Yeah, dynamic sermon preaching for yelling. Okay, so today we learned about the story of Jacob, and in the battle, and then Jacob, he could see the angels of God up and down, and then the letters is close to the heaven. And that story is very attractive and also very important to know the God and also the meaning of the God of the house of God, Bethel. So first, repeat that, let us read together. God is with you. So that is the first message today. So scripture, Genesis chapter 28, verse 16. So let us read together. When Jacob awoke from his sleep, he thought, surely the Lord is in this place, and I was not aware of it. This sentence is very important for our life. When I was young, when I was a child, at the time, when I sleep, I did not bring my blanket. But next morning, I found somebody covered my body with a blanket. So it's like this. Today, we think about the existence of God, but we don't know. We cannot see God, but we feel God is with us. The Holy Spirit around us. Here, look at this. Surely the Lord is in this place, and I was not aware of it. You cannot see, you cannot God, but God protects you. The Holy Spirit is with you, around you. Kenyana, Nuni, Paddy, Paddy. All of us, you know, you're from other countries, you came here South Korea, you feel you sometimes too much hard work, burdens, and have to write the master program, this program, you have to write. Sometimes you think about, oh, where is God? Where is God? God is around you. But we were not aware of it. And second, let us read together. Your dwelling place is Bethel. After Jacob, he recognized that God is with him. He named the place as Bethel. So let us read together. He was afraid and said, how awesome is this place? This is none other than the house of God. This is the gate of heaven. Hallelujah. As I mentioned, Bet means what? House. L means God. Okay, how about the Bethlehem? So repeat after Bet. Bet means house. Lechem means bread. So in Israel, Bethlehem, the city, Jesus Christ, he was born there. Bethlehem means house of bread. Bethlehem, the Beth El, the house of God. And that place, he experienced, Jacob experienced, so dark, darkness. And he could not see the house of God. Where is God? Where is God? That time, he wanted to bring just a pillow. But he slept well. Wow. I was thinking about our situation. Although our situation was not good, not perfect, it's like the stone, the pillow made of a stone. Our situation sometimes not good, not perfect. But there, we can see God. Yeah. We can sleep well. Let me tell you my personal story. It was the day, the last day, the oral defense, my PhD, you know, dissertation, oral defense. Here, it's me. Surrounding me, academic advisors, they are just, you know something? I want to ask you. So, and the early morning, I came, I arrived at the office, and I stacked the books. And at the time, I have my Apple Watch, the first version. And then suddenly, I could see my Apple Watch burning, my heartbeat. Go to the hospital. It was my first time to see. My heart was bumping. I was so nervous. It's like the Bethel, darkness. You know, the pillow made of stone. At the time, I grabbed my hands and I prayed to God. And I couldn't listen to the voice of God. The place, wherever you go, the dwelling place, there, I was in there with you. The El, Bethel, house of God. Kenyana, you were in Kenya, wherever you go, God is with you. And then I finished my prayer, and I felt some strength in my heart. And I couldn't say anything before my academic advisors. And I draw the map here in Israel, and they know better than me. And I draw and I explained well. And everybody said, oh, it's really good. And then my academic advisor, his name is Marvin Sweeney, and he's a Jewish scholar, he's like Santa Claus, and he said, I'm going to give you 5 minutes. Go outside. And we will talk about the wizard. And 5 minutes outside, I was waiting. For nine years, I was in the U.S. I'm just waiting the wizard. If they say no, then I have to go back to my country. I pray to God. God, please be with me and respond to my prayer request. After 5 minutes, somebody opened the door. That man is Marvin Sweeney, Santa Claus. He opened the door, and he said, and he grabbed my hand. Congratulations, doctor. Yeah! Wow! I could not forget that time, that moment. Wow, I'm so happy. I'm so happy. Our fellows, I want to ask you, think about your place, your home, your workplace. You might think, the stone pillar, nothing given to me. I'm not ready. So dark. And then look behind me. Nobody cares me. But bear in mind, God is with you. From there, God will show letter from the earth to the heaven. Angels of God up and down with you. There's a message out for today. Thank you. So, fellows, this weekend is a fortress of holiday. You will love your family, especially Koreans. When we meet Korean parents or relatives, they ask each other, when will you get married? Or do you have a job? Something like that. So stressful. I don't know the Laos or Burundi, they ask you when the family came back, do you have a job? Or are you getting married? Or something like that. Yeah, so sometimes so stressful, right? Especially young people. Yeah. But don't worry. God will be with you. God is taking care of you. Your place is better. House of God. Hallelujah. So let us praise the song together. My heart, your home together. My family left me. I was alone. like Jacob. Jacob, he tricked his father Isaac. He ran, he escaped from his house and from Beersheba to Haran. And he at last he arrived at the desert, so dark. But there he dreamed. He broke the stone as his pillow, and he could see the ladder from the earth to the heaven. The angels up and down, like the way around you. God is with you. God sent his angels around you. Your place becomes the house of God. God is with you. The house of God. Pray to God. Receive his message. Listen to the voice of God. Now let's pray together. Father, I pray to you. We declare our hands. We hand in hand, we pray to you. We want to receive the voice. We want to listen to the voice of God, the Lord. We want to see the angels. Although right now we cannot see, we were not aware of it, but we should. God is around us. Your angels are on us. Let us pray together. Our Father, thank you for today's message, Daedeok, the house of God. We sometimes complain about our circumstances. We sometimes forgot your existence. Father, please forgive us. May we see your letter from the heaven. May we see your angels who protect us. May we confess that you are always with us. Let us say that my dwelling place is God's place, the house of God, Bethel. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.